We've been married 12 years, and our wedding, it was not good. This is not my fault. This was my mom and my wife planned the wedding, and they're both cheap. So they cut corners. If we hire someone to do something in our house, I promise he does not do that job full time. He'll be fixing our dishwasher, and we're like, "Do you paint houses?" And he's like, "Yeah, I probably could paint houses, you know." His business card says, "How hard could it be?" Right? Can't be that hard. We got married on Friday the 13th. Got a pretty sweet deal on that. They were wide open. We're like, "What times are available?" They go, "Every one of them, all 24. You can call us that day if you want." Her brother married us. That was free. The photographer was just a buddy of ours that had he just bought a new camera. So we were like, "You gonna do our wedding?" Never done anything professionally, and it showed. His camera stopped working during it, and he started taking stuff out of it. Like, that would be the problem. Like, it's like, yeah, you know what? I bet they put too much stuff inside of it when they built it. You should yank some of those wires. That's not supposed to be in there like that. Our DJ was awful, and that's because we got my mom to hire the DJ. I don't know who thinks to ask someone in their 50s for DJ recommendations. No one ever is like, "Mom, are you in with the local DJ scene by any chance?" She hired someone older than her. He just had CDs, and this was when computers were doing real good. He got super drunk, played the same song 3 times in a row, White Wedding, which he said was by Billy Joel. He only had one leg, seriously, and that's fine, you know, no one cares until he starts messing up, and then you're like, "Why does he have one leg?"
The guy that we have that mows our yard is my wife. It's free, which is nice. I don't care for the tone it is mowed in. She wanted to mow it, and I was like, "Look, that's fine, but I want you to go tell every neighbor that you choose to do this." I don't want to always begin stopped like, "You the guy that makes his wife mow the..."
She started selling stuff online on Facebook Marketplace. And I found this out from a guy at my front door. I don't even really know what it is. I think it's just putting your home address on the open internet. She doesn't sell used cars. There's not like a big money coming in. She sells stuff that should be thrown away. She sold an old kid's folding chair for $5. Best case scenario, we receive $5. Worst case, our whole family is murdered.
My wife will tell me that she always says that I don't like the way she talks. And it's not her voice. I like the sound of her voice. That'd be a big problem, I think, if it was like, "It's your voice." I just hate it. It's the information that she chooses to tell me at times. We took a trip to Florida, to Fort Lauderdale. And her and our daughter are flying from Nashville, where we live. And I'm flying from Detroit. We're meeting at Fort Lauderdale's airport. I have to find them when they land. So I called her because I was about to take off. And I was like, "All right, what time do you guys leave?" She goes, "Noon." And it was 11:30 and they're still at home. I was like, "Laura, I don't know if you even know what an airport is. But if that plane was in our driveway, I don't think you could make it." And she said, "That's what time we leave for the airport. Our flight's not till 1:30. And I was like, all right. So what do you think I wanted to know when I asked that? Is that what you thought the best time you could give me was a time that means nothing to nobody? What time did you go to bed last night? Just tell me that, and I'll just look up all the planes that land in Florida, and I'll guess which one I think you're on. She said, I'm sorry I don't talk the way you want me to talk. I'm like, I want you to talk like a regular person, all right? Like you've been around people before, you know? We didn't talk in Florida, I'll tell you that. She
started selling stuff online on Facebook Marketplace. And I found this out from a guy at my front door. I don't even really know what it is. I think it's just putting your home address on the open internet. She doesn't sell used cars. There's like a big money coming in. She sells stuff that should be thrown away. She sold an old kids folding chair for $5. Best case scenario, we receive $5. Worst case, our whole family is murdered.
God forbid I go to a store she has a coupon for. I mean, I'll be walking into the parking lot, just get a call. Don't buy anything. I have a coupon. Like, do you think I'm going to come home and get that coupon? Is that what you think is about to happen? I'm going to try to pay more now that you call. I don't even know if Target allows that, but I'm going to try to negotiate up on this toothpaste. You better hope they don't ask me to round up. I'm rounding up. I hate coupons so much, and she's addicted to them. She will not let me leave. Like, I got a coupon. I'm like, I just feel so stupid. I'm buying deodorant, and I'm like, I don't have all the money, but I'm almost there. But I do have this coupon. One day, I hope to be able to pay full price. We are saving up as much as we can. My wife's always around, too. I feel just always, like, near, you know, especially about home. It's like I married a cat that I'm like, you just always on me. If I do any, I mean, if I go to the bathroom, she's like, I'm going to paint the bathroom door while you're in there. I'm like, you couldn't do it later? And I had all the time to do it. I thought I'd wait till you went in, and that's when I was going to start. If I eat something she doesn't approve of, she just pops up, man. I mean, I'll try to sneak it. I could eat an Oreo cookie in the attic at 3 a.m., and I would bet my life a light would cut on, and she'd be like, what are you doing up here? And if I questioned it, it was like, what are you doing up here? She's like, I'm always up here. This is when I do my attic stuff. Silent treatment is it's a very common thing. Everybody knows what it is. I think women are just born knowing it. I don't think you're taught it. I don't think it's like, my mom did it and her mom. Here's what made me think of that. I rewatched the movie Sixth Sense. And I'm not trying to do a Sixth Sense joke. This is a 20-year-old movie. I also have to spoil it, but it's 20 years old. So if you don't know by now, I don't know what to tell you, you know? And so he's dead the whole time. And I don't know. I mean, if you haven't seen it, it's a pretty big part of it, but for those that have, think about when you watched it. When we all saw this movie for the first time, none of us knew he was dead. That was the biggest surprise we've ever seen in our life, you know? We just thought his wife wasn't talking to him for like a year. That made more sense to us than him possibly being dead. What, do they show him dying? Yeah, that guy shoots him with a gun. That's how the movie starts. That's how obvious they're like, hey, he's dead. And we still watched it for 2 hours, just like, I know what this guy's going through, you know? This is a movie about marriage and how hard marriage is. Yeah. Even if you get shot, it's your fault.
If you get in those fights, like you'll be at home, like by you and your spouse, and you guys are not talking to each other, but you're in the house together. No kids, the house is quiet. And you just stay on the opposite ends, and then you pass each other in the hallway. That's like the funniest part of it, because you don't live in a mansion, you have one hallway. And you just didn't time it out right, and you just have to walk by each other like strangers. You're like, oh, excuse me. Sorry. Yeah, no, go ahead. She'll be watching TV. I'm like, ma'am, are you watching this? I couldn't tell. I was going to change it if you weren't watching it.
All right. So we got in the fight over the phrase one fell swoop. Just over this saying. And if you're, look, if you're a newlywed, you're like, well, that doesn't make sense. You're right. It doesn't. This is a double-digit married fight. This is when you've already done all the dish fighting or the putting your clothes away fighting. This is when they're trying to mentally break you. They got you almost how they want you, and this is the one that sends it over the edge. So my wife, she wanted to go visit her parents one weekend, and her parents are divorced, and which has been hardest on me, to be honest. That's something people don't talk about, you know? When you marry into divorce, I mean, they divorced because of her, not me, so why do I have to go to 50 different houses? So she wanted to go visit her parents, and shit, I want to do it in one fell swoop. Now, I've never heard my wife say the phrase one fell swoop. We've been together 20 years. She's never said it. And it felt like someone that day told her, hey, you should start using one fell swoop more. And she goes, I'm about to call my husband. It goes, perfect. Use it 40 to 50 times on him. So she calls me, and she goes, I want to go visit my parents. And I want to do it in one fell swoop. And I go, all right, let's do it in one fell swoop. She goes, I want to do it in one fell swoop. I go, let's do it in one fell swoop. You know, let's swoop it up. I'm down. And she kept saying it, one fell swoop, one fell swoop. I mean, over and over again. And then when she went to describe this one fell swoop trip, she goes, we'll go to my mom's, come home, then go to my dad's. And so I just like waited, and she didn't say anything. And I just go, that's not what one fell swoop means. And instead of possibly just being wrong, she goes, I know what one fell swoop means. I go, yeah, it doesn't sound like you do, all right? And we have the same last name. I can't have you out there in a one fell swoop conversation. What do you think two birds, one stone mean? Let's just go through them all. I don't know if you know any of these. She hangs up on me. So I get home. And you know when you walk home and you've been in a fight and you're like, all right, how long is this fight? Is it happening still? Is it over? I don't know. I got to fill it out, you know? She never uses words like sorry. I'd love to hear that. And that's a word she definitely doesn't know what it means. And I say it all the time. I walk around the house with just a sack of sorries, just handing them out all day. I try to give her some. Like, would you like to carry some of these? She's like, I don't have pockets, so I'm good. We didn't talk that whole night. I mean, we're just sitting there. Our daughter's like, we're watching TV, eating. And I'm like, hey, you know your mom's crazy, right? And she's like, did you do your homework? Or you don't want to be dumb like your dad? And then your daughter's just like, are y'all lunatics? So I'm laying on the couch. And my wife just came over, and she kisses me goodnight. And then she went to bed. And that was it. You know, that was like, I felt like it was her sorry, I guess. But she didn't say it. And so I was like laid there, and I'm just thinking about it. And you think about it a lot because you're like, all right. Because you learn the longer you get married, sometimes it's like, just let stuff go. You know, who cares? And the next morning I get up, and I kind of still wanted to talk about it because we didn't talk all night, you know? So I went into her. I was like, look, I got to tell you, I mean, it's just not what it means, you know? And that got it going real good. But I felt so good about this argument, you know? I thought about it all night. I was like, you got this one in the bag, man. You should bring it back up. I'm not trying to date her anymore. I like to win a fight. We're going to die together. I almost woke her up in her sleep. That's how much I was so excited. I almost just started shaking her going, it's not what it means. Our marriage almost ended in one fell swoop. So